Hello friends. In this video, we'll talk about the updated version of the silent ZigUSB relay, the first version of which I've already discussed earlier, link in the description. I'll remind you that the device is designed to work with the standard USB-A connector and, besides turning the power on and off, it performs an energy monitoring function. In addition, we will explore the additional capabilities of the device and test direct binding. Before we start, as per tradition, I ask you to like this video. It will help others interested in smart home topics find it and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. Special thanks to the channel's partner, the mind.in.ua store, which kindly provided me with this device for testing, making this review possible. The type of device, USB relay with energy monitoring. Interface, ZigBee. Hardware, ZigBee module based on CC2530 with a +20 by amplifier, power management, USB switch mic 2545A, energy monitoring, INA219. Maximum load current, up to 3.2 amperes. Data transfer via USB supported. External control, touch button. Function in the network, router. In the video description, you'll find a link to a full description of the device, including all technical data and diagrams, which, if you have the necessary skills, allows you to assemble it yourself. The device comes in a transparent plastic case, the standard AKN12, for which the relay is originally designed. On one side, you can see the touch button, which responds to touch. Above, and to the left of it, there's the load switch. On the other side, the module from eByte, E18, MS1PA2 PCB, based on the CC2530 chip, is visible. Standard USB-A connectors are located on the right and left. The hero of our review connects between the power source and the load, thereby allowing control of the power supply to it and monitoring energy consumption. I'll clarify again that this also supports data transmission. Pairing mode is activated upon first power-up, after removing the device from the coordinator, or by tripling the off-on cycle with a 2-second interval. We'll start compatibility checks with ZigBee 2 MQTT, with the current version at the time of testing being 1.35.3. Here, ZigStarLAN based on CC2652P is used as the coordinator. First, we'll test the default, out-of-the-box operation. Power is supplied to the relay and the pairing mode is activated. As of the test date, there's no official support yet, though it's expected soon. Meanwhile, an external converter is needed. We take it from the author's repository, the link to which you'll find in the video description. The converter code needs to be copied. Next, in the folder where the ZigBee 2 MQTT add-in is installed, create an empty file, which I named as in the repository, with a JS extension. Then, in the ZigBee 2 MQTT settings menu, find the external converters tab and click the plus sign. This adds a new blank line. Paste the name of the created file into it, then click send. After this, a reboot add-in button appears at the top right. Reboot. After rebooting, the device becomes supported. Let's explore its capabilities. Information about the relay, as I mentioned earlier, it acts as a ZigBee router, meaning it can transmit data for other devices, thereby increasing the capacity and coverage of the network. Moving on to the expose page. For a relay, even considering energy monitoring, there are quite a few options. The first is action, events from the touch button, followed by relay control and button operation modes. Then come the energy monitoring sensors, current, voltage, and power, setting the update interval, CPU temperature, and operating duration in seconds. This is how the device appears in Home Assistant, where it arrives through MQTT integration. Here are all the same options. Manual relay switching via the button. The device is completely silent, with no sounds when switching. I set the data update interval to 10 seconds. The work of energy monitoring sensors in real time. Data updates occur within the specified interval. Restart is an interesting and convenient parameter designed for power cycling connected devices. Here, a value is set in seconds for which the power will be turned off, then it automatically turns back on. The plus is that only one parameter is transmitted to the device. In Home Assistant, this field corresponds to a number object. To set the value, a special service is used. You send the duration in seconds for which the relay will turn off the power and then turn it back on. Here's the same block in YAML. By the way, in this way, the server can even reboot itself, as it doesn't need to turn the relay back on. It will turn on by itself. The option Link to Output connects the touch button with the power switch. Similar to the mode of disconnecting keys from the relay in Acura switches, the button can be deactivated and used as a logical controller. For this, there is a switch type field, where you can set the mode to either single or multi-click. Other options are not used and will likely be removed. Now pressing the button does not toggle the power. It can be used in automations. Here are the events that come to the action sensor in multi-click mode, single, double, and even triple press. The bind command item sets the type of command sent in direct binding mode. Let's test a couple of main ones. First, we create a link between the button and some device. For this, we go to the bind tab and in the source endpoint menu, select the first one. In the next menu, select the device you want to control. For the test, I'll take a socket so that it can be turned on and off. Also, select the first endpoint and the on-off cluster. Then press the bind button to establish the connection. Done. The connection is established. Now let's check how it will work in different modes. Currently, the button is disconnected from the relay and the command type is set to toggle. This command turns the socket on and then immediately off. A brief supply of power. The next mode, the button is disconnected, command type is on off. In this case, pressing the button sends the command to turn on. It doesn't know how to turn off, only to turn on. Let's repeat the same, but return the button control to the USB relay. The command is toggle. Everything is the same, only the key also controls the USB power. And the fourth option, the on-off command, the button controls the relay. Here's the interesting part. Pressing the button both turns the socket on and off, and everything works in counter phase with the USB. Turning one on turns the other off and vice versa. Now let's check compatibility with ZigBee Home Automation, the native integration of Home Assistant. Here, a USB ZigBee stick from Sonoff is used. I initiate pairing mode, and the system detects the relay, showing that there are several objects for control. This is good. Excluding hidden technical entities, three objects were discovered. A switch, some binary sensor, and the CPU temperature. Only the switch can be used, and it works but in inverse mode. Currently, the USB power is turned off. In this position, it's turned on. There are no options for energy monitoring, logical events, or button mode settings. Only power control is available. And the last system with which I can check compatibility is Sonoff iHost, a local smart home management hub. You can find a review of it in the link in the description. The current firmware as of the test date is 1.13.3. ZigUSB automatically enters pairing mode after disconnecting from the coordinator. On iHost, we activate the search and soon it discovers and connects the new device. The relay connected, but unfortunately, even the most basic support is not available. With iHost, as of the test date, it cannot be used. Despite the use of the widely popular USB-A format, which is used to power many devices, I have not come across any factory equivalents of the hero of this review. Of course, there are some options, for example, the Sonoff Mini with the same connectors, but it's Wi-Fi and without energy monitoring. For ZigBee, there are relays with dry contacts that can be powered via USB and control a 5-volt line, but those too lack energy monitoring, not to mention options like power cycling. Therefore, ZigUSB is a very interesting and useful device that will be indispensable in some cases. I remind you that this is an open source project, and with the appropriate skills, the device can be assembled independently. That's all. I hope this video was useful and interesting to you. I would appreciate your likes. They help promote it on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the description, you will find all the necessary links to the project website, the store where you can order the hero of the review, other videos on this topic. There you will also find a link to my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and group for discussions on smart home topics. Thank you for your attention. Until next time, peace to everyone.